Jai Bharat everyone, welcome to Advait Achievers. Children, in our previous video, we have been discussing the paleontological evidences and under that we have discussed various examples. Moving on, the last point we discussed in that was the phylogenetic lineage. That means what? Phylogeny. It is the ancestral history that we are going to talk about. And in this section, we are going to talk about the phylogeny of horse, that is the ancestral history of the modern horse. That is, what type were the ancestors of the modern horse which is existing nowadays, right? So let us take a look at the phylogeny of horse. The names which you are seeing here, Eohippus, Oligohippus, Merychippus, Pleohippus and the modern horse. So this is the modern horse which is existing or is a present day form, and these all are the ancestral forms which existed in the earlier times, right? Now, before discussing the evolutionary history of the modern horse, so the scientific name is Equus, right? We need to understand geological time scale. Now, let's understand that, okay? Okay, geological time scale. Now, to understand how life evolved, right? The history of Earth has been divided into six eras. You may be seeing here that I have written a few things over here. You know, picture is describing so many things. But out of that, what important is, we'll go one by one. Okay, ठीक है, फिर से कि evolution किसी का समझने के लिए हमें पहले उसका geological हमें time scale समझना है. और to understand that, the history of Earth, उनको six eras में divide कर दिया गया है, right? Starting from the, यहाँ पे आपको Hadean लिखा पढ़ रहा होगा, right? But that is the Earth formation. Now that time, okay, that time is called, this era is called as Azoic era, okay? Right? Now during this time, it was just that the Earth was being formed and all that. Okay, after that comes the Archaeozoic era. Alright, and then comes Proterozoic era, Paleozoic era, Mesozoic era and Cenozoic era. So the developmental history of Earth, simultaneously the formation of organisms, that all can be divided into six eras. In these six eras, these three, that is the Paleozoic, Mesozoic and Cenozoic, they are referred to as the modern eras. Alright, so these three are the modern eras. These modern era are further divided into the periods, right? You may be getting to read over here. So, say the Paleozoic era is divided into various periods. Mesozoic era is divided into Triassic, Jurassic and Cretaceous, and the Cenozoic era is having the tertiary period. Now in each period, it is showing you what kind of organisms, kis prakar ke organisms exist hona shuru hue, right? So say if we talk about, simple, if I talk about the Paleozoic era, to uske alag alag periods hai, right? Jaise kya ho gaya? Cambrian period. To usme kya tha? First fish came into existence, then the chordate animals, फिर आया ऑर्डोविशियन, उसमें मेजर डाइवर्सिफिकेशन ऑफ एनिमल्स हुआ, Then Silurian, that is the first vascular plants came into existence at that time. So these are these various periods which tell us which type of organisms existed at that time, right? Okay, and further these periods are divided into epochs. Ye periods jo hai, they are further divided into epochs. ये हमें याद रखना है. Why I am telling you this term epochs? The reason being, जब हम हॉर्स का इवोल्यूशन पढ़ेंगे तब कौन से पीरियड में या कौन से एपोक में किस टाइप का हॉर्स एग्जिस्टेड था, राइट, उसके बारे में हम पढ़ने वाले हैं. सो वी हैव टू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ द एपोक. आई होप आई एम क्लियर इन दिस. सो अगेन आई एम मेकिंग इट अ सिंपलर फॉर्म. हम यहाँ पे याद रख सकते हैं. ओके, अर्थ की हिस्ट्री डिवाइडेड इनटू 6 एराज. ओके, दिस इज क्लियर. 6 एराज, दी 6 एराज आर फर्दर डिवाइडेड इनटू द पीरियड्स. But out of this, these three modern era we are going to discuss, okay? And periods are further divided, these periods are further divided into epochs. Right? So remember this. Make it very clear. The history of the earth can be divided into 6 eras. These eras can be divided or are further divided into periods. And periods are further divided into epochs. Clear? Alright. So let us move on to our next slide. Right? Okay. Before moving to the understanding part of what was the phylogeny of horse, we need to understand a term called splint bone. Alright? A term called splint bone. Okay. Now, the phylogeny of horse was described by Othniel Marsh. Okay? It was described by Othniel Marsh. अब splint bone माने reduced digit. हाँ, जैसे हम digits माने क्या, fingers, ठीक है. तो अगर हम अपनी ये 5 fingers की बात कर रहे हैं, अगर मैं इसका size reduce होके बाकियों का size reduce हो जाता है, ठीक है, ऐसे, और ये एक रह रहा है, ये reduce हो गया है सब. One is this like this. तो क्या हो रहा है, बाकी की साइज रिड्यूस हो रही है. दिस वन हैज़ रिमेन लॉन्ग. दिस इज दिस बेसिक कंसेप्ट हैज़ वर्कड इन द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ हॉर्स. ठीक है, रिडक्शन ऑफ द डिजिट्स, अंडरस्टूड. तो ये दोज रिड्यूस डिजिट्स वी रिफर टू एज स्प्लिंट बोन्स. राइट, सी हियर, इफ यू टेक अ लुक एट, यू मे सी दैट इट इज शोइंग अस व्हाट द फिफ्थ वन, फोर्थ वन, थर्ड वन एंड सेकेंड वन. So this has a reduced digit that has become splint. Even the first also is not visible. 5 hoti hai na, correct? So as such 5 should be there, but you can see 5 is reduced. Same way the first was also reduced. Okay, so what remains, what we are able to see is these 3. So the fifth and the first are, you can say, they have become splint bones. They are reduced digits. Alright, clear everyone? Yeah, moving on to now the phylogeny of horse, that was again, remember, described by Othniel Marsh. Now you remember in the beginning of our lecture, I had displayed a picture of different horses, right, from the first form to the modern form, correct? So now we are going to discuss is the first form of horse, or you can say the scientific name of it is Eohippus. Yeah, Hyracotherium, Eohippus. Its scientific name is Eohippus and it is commonly called dawn horse. Common name is dawn horse. Now you see, here this term has come, epoch. In which epoch was this Eohippus present? Because this we have got to learn. about the horses from the fossils. It is a part of the paleontological evidence, right? But they were available in such a good condition from the rocks that its size and many features we could get to know from it, right? So this existed in the Eocene epoch. This existed in the Eocene epoch, correct? And its age was some 60 million years ago, this was present. So we may write here 60 MYA, that indicates 60 million years ago it existed, right? Its height, height was 28 centimeters. Here you are able to see 0.4 meters. But it is approx what I am giving you an idea that it is 28 centimeter it was. 28 centimeter, right? Then fingers, how many fingers did it have? Jab hum fingers ki baat karte hain, you have to understand I am talking about the forelimb, alright? Forelimb, front legs. Right? And when I'll use the term toes, means hum hind legs ki baat kar rahe hain. Theek hai. So fingers, it had four fingers. And out of those four fingers, from the figure itself you can see, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Mane first wala nahi dikh raha. Hai na? To kya hua tha? First became splint. It got reduced. Right? So, out of this four fingers, first had become splint, right? The first one had become splint. Alright, coming to the next, toes. Now we are talking about the hind limb. It had how many toes? Three toes. And out of those three, second, third and fourth were functional. Okay, so let us write them down. Second, third and fourth were functional, right? Second, third and fourth were functional and first and fifth were splint. And say first and fifth were splint. Clear? So this was about it. Now you can also see the tooth structure which is shown, right? So let us talk about its molars. We are basically talking about the molars. Molars were very small. It had very small crown and were grinding teeth. So very small crown, right? And what kind of a teeth they were? Grinding teeth. Right? So this was the first form, ancestral form we are discussing of our modern day horse equus, which is called, the scientific name is Eohippus. The common name is Dawn horse. Existed in the Eocene epoch some 60 million years ago. It was 28 centimeters in height. Had four fingers, out of which the first finger had become splint. There were three toes, in which the second, third and fourth were functional. First and fifth had become splint. And it had very small crown molars and they were grinding teeth. Right? This is clear to everyone? Okay. Moving to the next. Okay? Moving to the next. The next form is called Mesohippus. Okay? Mesohippus. And its common name is called intermediate horse. Right? Mesohippus, it was commonly known as intermediate horse. Right? Okay. Which epoch did it exist in? It existed in the Oligocene epoch. Right? In the Oligocene epoch, it existed some 40 million years ago. In height, you can see I have written here 0.6 meters, that is 60 centimeters. So 60 centimeters, right? Fingers, it had three functional fingers, right? Three functional fingers. So which means what? Do jo hongi wo uski splint ho chuki hai, correct? So the first and the fifth became splint. See, you can see here. Fifth yahan pe hum dikha rahe hain. First dikh nahi raha hoga. So second, third and fourth you are able to see. So three fingers are functional. The first and the fifth has become splint. So say first and fifth. What has happened to them? They have become splint. Clear? Alright? Okay. Now, toes also. It has three toes. Okay? So, in that also, second, third and fourth are functional. First and third has become splint. I repeat, second, third and fourth is functional. Second, third, fourth is functional and first and fifth is splint. First, fifth is becoming splint. Right? So then, the molars. We will write molars a little down. Right? So let us put down about molars over here. Yes, what kind of a molars did it had? Same type like the previous one. Very small crown and grinding teeth. Very small crown and grinding teeth. Right? So this was this Mesohippus. The common name being the intermediate horse, which existed in the Oligocene period 40 million years ago. Moving to the next, right? And that is called Merychippus. Okay? Here, Merychippus. Okay? The scientific name is Merychippus. Alright, commonly called as the ruminating horse. Ruminating horse. Alright, it existed in the Mesocene epoch. How much before or how long before? Some 25 million years ago. Its height, you can see I have written here 1 meter. So it is say 100 centimeters. How many fingers? Only third functional, you can see over here. Dheere dheere beta, isme jo cheez hume samajna hai, right? Wo bahut important cheez hai. I am coming to that point. Okay, first just understand that only third functional, second and fifth splint. First already reduced ho hi chuka tha. Correct? I repeat, only third remained functional. Only third functional. Theek hai? second and fifth splint. Right? And toes, same thing, only third functional. अब कहीं ना कहीं हमारे दिमाग में ये बात आनी चाहिए कि ऐसा क्यों हो रहा था, why it was like that. Now just imagine any animal when is walking on a four legged, तो ये palm ऐसे होगा, हाँ, पर ये horse को दौड़ना था तो उसको ऐसे आना था. अगर ऐसे आता, पांचों की पांचों जो उसकी fingers है या जो भी digits है वो ऐसे रहती, तो वो उसको चलने में, दौड़ने में तो problem होना था. तो एक चीज कुछ ऐसा चाहिए था कि जो ऐसे लंबा स्ट्रांग हो जाए और बाकी का स्टफ ऐसे सिंपल यहाँ से रिड्यूस होता जाए, जिसकी वजह से ये जो सेंट्रल पोर्शन है वो स्ट्रांग हो. राइट, दिस सेंट्रल पोर्शन शुड बिकम स्ट्रांग एंड दीज साइड वंस कैन बी दी सपोर्टिंग वंस. सो दैट व्हाट विल हैपन नाउ, देन इट विल बिकम ईजी फॉर इट टू रन. ऐसे दौड़ना उसके लिए फिर ईजी हो जाए. समझ में आया? Understood. So slowly, steadily, what happened was that these digits, they started reducing so that this central portion, the center one, the third finger, it became more and more, say, consider in comparison to the others, it was longer. लंबी होते गई, right? और ज़्यादा strong होते गई. समझ में आया? जो कि पूरा उसका support, body weight का support उस पर उसको कर सके. Understood. So that is why this reduction in fingers, right, reduction in toes. Understood. So that is why it is important. This feature is playing a major role in the evolutionary portion, right? And simultaneously you can see that the height of the animal is also increasing. अभी के जो घोड़े हम देखते हैं कितने height में होते हैं, है ना, हमसे भी कभी कभार तो ऐसे ऊंचे होते हैं. So this is what the evolution process is there. Understood. And the last point in this remains is the molars. What type of molars it had? Now here there is a different thing in case of this tooth structure also, that the crown became long and the teeth were grazing type. Okay, grazing teeth. So you can write over here to be as crown long right and grazing teeth. Crown long and grazing teeth, right? So this was Merychippus, right? The next in this order, right, comes is the Pliohippus. Okay, so let us see that now. Pliohippus. So the scientific name is Pliohippus, right? Its common name is Pliocene horse. Epoch, Pliocene epoch. Right? This is clear to everyone? This consider it as this as I. Here there is a spelling error. P-L. Pliocene. So P-L-I-O. P-L-I-O. Pliocene horse. Right? Yeah. And existed in the Pliocene period some 10 million years ago. Its height you can see 1.25 meters. So approximate I am writing an average of 108 centimeters. Okay? Yeah? Okay. Now fingers की बात करते हैं. अब यहाँ पे figure पे खास आपको ध्यान देना है. ओके एवरी वन पे अटेंशन. नाउ व्हाट हैपन, जैसे थोड़ी देर पहले मैंने बोला था कि धीरे 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 ऐसे होता गया कि बाकी जो सारे डिजिट्स थे वो साइड से रिड्यूस होते गए होते गए होते गए, और एक जो सेंटर वाला मेन वन था, राइट, दैट इज द थर्ड वन, राइट, दैट बिकेम मोर एंड मोर लॉन्गर एंड स्ट्रोंगर, राइट. सो इन केस ऑफ फिंगर्स वी कैन से दैट ओनली थर्ड फंक्शनल. ओके, यू कैन सी इन द फिगर इटसेल्फ, ओनली थर्ड फंक्शनल, करेक्ट. व्हाट हैपन टू दैट थर्ड वन, कंपेरिजन टू द अदर्स, इट बिकेम मोर एंड मोर लॉन्ग. क्या हुआ, ज्यादा ज्यादा लंबा था एंड मोर स्ट्रांग ऑल्सो. सो इट बिकेम लॉन्ग एंड स्ट्रांग, इट बिकेम लॉन्ग and strong, clear? And same thing happened in case of the toes as well, right? In case of the toes as well, the third remained functional and it became long and strong. So the same thing, right? That only third functional, it became long and strong, right? And so then how about the molars? Same, crown was long and was grazing type. So crown long and grazing teeth. Right? So this was Pleohippus. Clear, children? This figure, huh? Pay attention on this part very much. And slowly, this helped it, why? To became that leg to be more stronger and stronger, ताकि जिसकी मदद से वो fast, धीरे धीरे ऐसा हुआ कि उसके legs जो थे, legs माने, I'm talking about forelimb as well as the hind limb, वो modify हुए, और modify होते गए कैसे? कि जैसे उसका वो जो सेंट्रल पोर्शन था जो फिंगर का द बोन दैट बिकेम मोर लॉन्गर एंड स्ट्रोंगर ताकि वो फास्ट रनर्स हॉर्सेज आर फास्ट रनर्स राइट अच्छा दौड़ते हैं तो उसको उस चीज में मदद हो राइट सो दिस वॉज प्लियोहिपस एंड नाउ फाइनली कम्स अवर मॉडर्न हॉर्स राइट जिसका scientific name is equus. Its scientific name is equus. Right? Common name, commonly called modern horse. Which epoch? Pleistocene epoch, and existence is 0.5 million years, right? So Pleistocene. Pleistocene epoch, age we can say 0.5 million years ago. And this is still existing, right? The height. Now height is 150 centimeter. यहाँ पे 1.6 meters लिखा है. तो वो एक 150 centimeters to 180 centimeters कहते हैं. 150 to 180 centimeters. Okay? Clear? Fine. Again, in case of say fingers, we can very well see only third is functional. Right, only third functional became more long and strong. So only third functional, it became long and strong. Alright? And same way, the toes also. That only third is functional and it became long and strong. The same thing. Only third functional became long and strong, right? And molars, they had a long crown and teeth were grazing teeth. So long crown and grazing teeth, right? So with this, we are done with the evolution of horse, the phylogeny of horse as given by Orthoneal Marsh. So here what I have put up now is the entire description of what we have been discussing, right? Of what we have discussed till now, right? This first form was Eohippus, right? Dawn horse commonly called. Existed in the Eocene period and its characters. Same way, children, in brief, if you want to remember, prepare a chart like this. This will help you to remember. Alright? So, with this we are done with the paleontological evidences. In the next video, we will be discussing about the biogeographical evidences. Thank you. Jai Bharat.